Hello friends, you are watching ArrowDire Plus, the professional CAD-CAM solution provider. Let's get started.
Hello viewers, today I'm going to show a specific technique of CFD transfer analysis using SolidWorks, known as free surface technique. Actually, this type of technique is utilized when there is heterogeneous fluid mixing. So this is a very simple example. In this example, we will be taking tea inside a cup, and certain amount of this cup will be filled up with tea, and the top part will be filled up with air. And in this analysis, we will see temperature at different locations, temperature at the inside and outside of this cup surfaces. So without wasting time, let us start our analysis. You can see this is the model. Let us have a segmented view of this model to understand it in a better way. Up to this one is filled up with tea, and the top part from here to this portion is filled up with air. And we can find temperature at any location. In this analysis, we'll find temperature at the inside surface of this cup. At the same time, we'll find out temperature at the outside surface of this cup. Right? So while modeling these things, what we have done, we have taken this portion as a solid, and this was unmasked solid. And while applying initial conditions, we have to disable this solid and that to be considered as T. Right? And for starting the flow simulation environment, we need to start from flow simulation here. And next to that, we need to start with wizard. Default name of the project we are keeping as project 1. Next to that, we need to select unit systems. We're considering SI unit system, and from main parameters, we can select temperature as degree Celsius. Next to that, we need to consider what type of analysis it is. You can consider this one as an internal analysis, or we can consider this one as external analysis also. Our aim should be to see the temperature at the internal surface, by the same time external surface also. Let us consider this one as external analysis, and we are considering fluid flow, conduction, and as it is a free surface technique, so definitely it will be a transient analysis, so it is dependent on time. We are considering this total time for this simulation as 60 seconds, and output time step equal to 1 second. That is, after each 1 second, we will set the results. We can depend on gravity, and the direction of gravity will be y, as indicated by this green arrow downwards. So it will be along y, it is -9.81 meter per second square, and along z it will be 0. And finally, it is a free surface technique, as we are considering heterogeneous fluid mixing. It is a fluid mixing of air and tea. So it is a free surface technique. Next to that, we need to consider different fluids. Gases, it will be air, and liquid, it will be tea. In the fluent database, tea is not there, so we have to select it from user defined property. We have already defined this one with specific properties of tea is defined here itself. So we can see here we have selected two different fluids, air and tea. Next to that, material, we can select material is made up of ceramics, and it is composed of 99.9% of aluminum. Next to that, default roughness parameters we are considering. And finally, you can see that thermodynamic parameters, pressure is 10135 Pascal, and temperature will be 20 degrees centigrade. Concentration, that means initially it will be filled up with air. Solid parameters, it will be having temperature of 20 degrees centigrade. And from initial conditions, actually, we need to provide those solid component as tea, right? Let us finish this. Now we can see this is the temperature domain. We need to make this domain a little bit small to make the simulation time smaller. just move the domain, move the time. So better to make that domain as small as possible, and we should see that all the components should be inside this domain. Nothing should be outside, right? Let us see it in a better way. You see it from other side. Okay, fine. Let us hide this domain. Next to that, we need to apply different materials and boundary conditions. Material is already provided, so no need of applying material again. First of all, we need to apply our initial conditions. That means the downward location, we are having some solid that to be disabled as solid and that to be converted as tree. So conditions, initial condition, and you can select that solid from main geometry. Let us select that one and that to be disabled as solid component, and that to be considered as T at a temperature of 100 degrees centigrade. So we're considering the temperature to be 100 degrees centigrade. Go and check. Done. We have provided some lead at this location that is not visible, that can be viewed from the geometry itself. Let us see the geometry and make that lead visible. This is the lead, we can see it here, right? Okay. Next to that, we need to apply our boundary conditions. Insert boundary condition. It will be atmospheric pressure at the exit location here itself. Brain check, boundary condition is applied. Next to that, we need to find our goals, and for finding goals, insert surface goals. First one will be average temperature of fluid inside this surface. Let us select that inside surface. Brain check, first goal is defined. We can rename this one as average temperature of fluid at inner surface. Done. Now we need to select for the outer surface. Again, goals, insert surface goals, and it will be average temperature of fluid at the outer surface. You can select the handle also. Go and check, and we can rename this one as average temperature fluid at the outer surface. Done. Next, we can go for meshing. We can have a local mesh to have better representation. Mesh, insert local mesh, and we need to select the surfaces. We can go for finer refinement. Let us go up to fifth level of refinement to yourself. And advanced refinement, we are going up to level 2. Done. Now another thing is needed. Before starting simulation, we need to go for something else, like here. We need to select calculation control options, and from saving, we can select periodic from here, and we can select parameters like pressure, temperature, etc. Okay, done. Now we can run it. We have already simulated this one in project 2. We can view the results from project to yourself. Let us view it from here. You can load the results. Results are loaded. First of all, we want to see different cut plots of pressure and temperature from different planes. So insert cut plots, and we want to see temperature fluid through front plane. You can see vectors also. Let us see. This is the distribution of temperature through front plane. And to view this one in a better way, we can do something else, like we can insert this transient explorer. From this one, you can see it or view it in a better way. Let us view the transient explorer. With this transient explorer on, we can see it in a better way. You can see the temperature distribution. Let us close it, and we can do something else, like transient explorer, we can make it off. Now we can view it in a different way, like we can play this. It is showing this temperature distribution across different planes. Let us clear and hide this one. Is the first one, clear and hide this one. Done. Next to that, we want to see surface plots. That means across the surface, you can see the temperature distribution. Let us see the surface plot. Across the surface, you can see temperature is actually constant. Let us clear and hide this one. Our aim is to see the temperature at inner surface and outer surface, right? So we can see it from goals. Excluding that one, we can see something else like XY plot. It will show the temperature distribution or pressure or velocity, anything across the height that can be viewed from XY plot, right? So we can see it from XY plot. Inside XY plot, you can see parameters like pressure and temperature of fluid. Across that line, we can select it from the geometry. That line is sketch number 19, and that is selected. So we can view it right now, and that is XY plot, right? XY plot, edit definition, and we can view it directly from here, or we can transfer it to Excel also. Let us export this XY plot to Excel. First one is temperature distribution across height. Initially, temperature was increasing. After some time, it was constant for some time. And again, after a specific height, that temperature is decreasing. Because the thing is, after a certain height, we are having air. So for the air particles, we are having less temperature, right? So the temperature distribution actually clearly visible here itself. Initially, at zero height, temperature is 60 degrees centigrade, and as height is increasing, temperature is coming to 100 degrees centigrade. It was constant for some time, and when the T was not there at the top level of this curve, when there was the existence of air in that location, you can see temperature is decreasing, and finally temperature has come down to 43.47 degrees centigrade, right? Next one is pressure. You can see pressure is constant, it is not changing at all, right? Let us close it, right? Next to that, you need to see our actual things, that is our goals, what we wanted to see, temperature at the inside surface and also outside surface that can be viewed from goal plots. Insert goal plots, and you want to see all the goals, both the goals, that is temperature of fluid at outer surface and also inner surface, that can be exported to Excel also. Let us export to Excel and view it in a better way. This is the data. First one is average temperature of fluid. You can see here at inner surface. You can see it is variable because at a different height, you can see temperature is different, right? So it is variable. And finally, after 65 numbers of iterations, temperature at the inner surface is 54.92 degrees centigrade, that is approximately 55 degrees centigrade. After 65 numbers of iterations, this is the temperature at the inner surface. Next one is temperature at the outer surface. You can see that is also not constant because we have selected different portions. We have selected the bottom surface, the handle, and also the side walls. So the temperature is not constant. And finally, you can see that temperature after 65 numbers of iterations, it is 44.2554 degrees centigrade, right? Let us close it. So this is all about our simulation. Now instead of stopping it here, we can go for some kind of parametric study. That means you can do something else, like means you can vary the temperature of this city. You can see temperature at different locations, right? This is not actually mixing of tea and air. This is actually how tea is losing heat by convection and conduction both ways, right? So this is all about our today's analysis. Thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you again. Bye. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. And if you have any kind of doubts, please write to me. Thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you again. Bye.